exclusive intervals. That is, the lower limit is included as well as upper limit is included within the class. This we have discussed. And today, third question, we'll be taking third question. Now read the third question once. The marks of 24 candidates in the subject of mathematics are given below. Okay, 24 candidates are there and mathematics marks are provided to us. Okay, and the maximum marks are 50. So out of 50, so till 50, we have the class. Okay, make a frequency distribution taking class number 0 to 10, 10 to 20. You can see the difference between second and third question. There we have in second question, we have the class intervals 1 to 10, 11 to 20. 21 to 30. Here,
not clear.
Okay. Clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, earlier in second question, we were having class intervals 1 to 10, 11 to 20, 21 to 30. Okay. Here, lower limit was included as well as upper limit was included. You can see lower limit was included as well as upper limit was included. Equal to sign was there. But now in this question, you have to take class intervals from 0 to 10. Okay. In this question, see here, 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. Okay. Now the question arises, if any data, any student have got marks 10, where it will go? Whether to the first class, second class, which class it will go? First or the second?
First.
First. Okay, why not second? Because 10 is there. So, see here. Here we can easily differentiate.
More than 10.
Okay. It's 10 marks. So, see here equal to. Okay, if we write inclusive, it will be like this. 0. If we are writing inclusive. Okay. Now, see here. If it comes 10. This equation is satisfied because x is equal to 10. Here as well, x is equal to 10. Both the equations are satisfied. It means 10 can go to this class as well, can go to this class as well. Okay? It can go to this class as well as to this class. Now, some students may put in first class, some student may put in second class. So, there will be discrepancy. That is, there will be difference between the representation. Yes? So, see here. What kind of these class were? They were inclusive class intervals. Why? Upper limit was included, lower limit was included as well. Okay. And here, if any student who have got marks 10.5, we won't be able to enter. We won't be able to enter. And therefore, there is discontinuity. There is discontinuity between 10 and 11. There is discontinuity between 20 and 21. But here, what we do, we exclude the upper limit. We exclude the upper limit. It means lower limit is included. Lower limits are included. Upper limits are excluded. You can see now. Now, where the 10 will go? First class or the second class? Where 10 is going to be? It will go to the second class because these are exclusive class intervals. These are exclusive class intervals. Here we have the inclusive class intervals. That is, lower limit is included, upper limit is included. But here, see, 0 to 10, again 10 to 20 is starting, 20 to 30 is starting. So here, these are exclusive form. These are having exclusive class intervals. That is, we are excluding the upper limits. We are excluding the upper limits. Understood now the difference between inclusive class intervals and exclusive class intervals? In inclusive, we include the upper limits. Lower limits are always included, but upper limits are included in inclusive class intervals, whereas exclusive class intervals, upper limits are excluded. And mainly we are going to use this form. When we draw the when we draw the histograms or when we draw the frequency polygon, we are going to use the exclusive form. And why we are going to use the exclusive form? Because there will be continuity. You can see the discontinuity. We can't enter marks between 10 and 11. But here we can enter. If it is 10.1 marks, we won't be able to enter here. But here we can enter 10.1 marks in second class. So there is continuity. There is continuity. Therefore, we are going to follow mainly this class intervals. That is exclusive class intervals. What? Why exclusive? Because upper limits are excluded in this form. Upper limits are excluded in this form. This is clear now? Okay, where 20 will go? Second class or the third class? In third class it will go. It will go in third class. So we are going to exclude the upper limit. You can see equal to sign we have removed. So we have excluded the upper limits. Okay. So it will up to 9.999 will enter. As it comes 10, as x equal to 10 comes, it will go in the second class. This is clear. Okay. Now we are going to make the third marks of the 24 candidates in the subjects. This thing is clear. This is very important. The whole chapter is based on over it. Okay. Now make the table, frequency table, everyone. Make the table, class interval 0 to 10, 10 to 20. So first is the marks. Here we have the marks. Okay. This is the class intervals. Class interval that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. Here we have the tally marks. And here we have the frequency. Okay. And what's the equation here? See here, these are exclusive or inclusive? They are exclusive. Therefore, any data 0, 10, it's excluded. Upper limit is excluded, no equal to sign. X, 10, 20, 20, 30, 40, 30, 40. This is clear. Okay, so we will start the tally marks. 45. Where it will go? 45. Keep checking. I may make a mistake. 45, 48, 15. Okay, do remind me whenever I make the mistake instantly. 15, 23. Where it is going to be? 23. In this class, 23, 30. Now check 30, whether it will go here or here. 30, which one? First, second, third, fourth, fifth. Which class interval it will go? 30. Fourth. No third. It is here. It is always less than 30, not equal to 30. So it will go to the fourth class. It will go to the fourth class. Always remember, these are not included. Exclusive class interval means these are not included. It means 30 comes, it will go in this class interval. 10 comes, it will go in this class interval. Because these are excluded. Upper limits are excluded. Okay, 30, 35. Here. 40. 40 where it will go? This or this? In fifth. Last. Fifth it will go. Last it will go. 40, 11. 29. 0. Lower limit is included. 3. 12, 48, 50. 50? Where should put 50? Where should we put 50?
The last one.
Last one we can't put. So we need one more class interval.
Sixth one.
Sixth one. We have to make one more class interval because 50 marks are as well there. So 50 to 60. This is our sixth class interval. Now many books they will put in this. 50 marks they will put in this. Many books you will see they are putting here. Some books they are putting here. In last interval. So there is a discrepancy here. Some books you will see it will be put here. 50 marks they are going to put here. And some books they are creating one more class interval and putting here. So we'll go here. 18, 30 years, 15 years, 30, 11. Okay, we already put 5. 11, 42. 23, 2, 3, 44. So here, see here, last one, many books will consider it here. In the last they used to put, okay? And you can do as well like this. Okay, now how so many are there? Also write the total. No need of writing this one. This is just for
we have to write the total.
Total? Right. It's for mainly for checking whether you counted all the marks or not. 4, 5, 6, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1. Now total them once. How many are getting? 10, 20, 24. It means you haven't skipped. By totaling, you can check. 24 students were there. You haven't skipped any. This is clear. Or in some books, if you avoid the last one, the one will be included here. You'll get 7 here. Okay. You may put like that as well. Okay. This is clear. Total 24. This is clear. Always remember, upper limit is excluded. It is exclusive form. And mainly we will be going to use exclusive form only. Okay. Mainly we are going to use the exclusive form. Okay. Now see here, there will be questions where inclusive form will be given and we'll be converting it into exclusive form. That we'll do later. Okay. Third question is clear. Fourth one, a quantity which can vary from one individual to another is called a, which is varying from one, like height is varying. It is called as. Variables. Sizes of shoes are dash values. Are they continuous variable or the discrete? Which kind of variable?
Discrete variable.
Discrete variable, because we cannot find the shoes between the two variables. Between the two shoe sizes, we cannot find. Okay. Daily temperature is a continuous or discrete variable? Daily temperature.
Continuous.
It's continuous. It can take any value. The range of the data is 7, 13, 6, 25, 18, 20, 16. Range means what is the lowest, what is the highest, what is the difference between them, how much spread it is, range. So from lowest to highest, how much it is lying. So subtract 6 from 25, you get 19. So 19 is the range. Difference between the lowest value, between the highest value and the lowest value, 19. Okay, in a class interval 35 to 46, the lower limit is 35, upper limit is 46. Okay, find the actual lower class limits, upper class limits and the mid values of the classes. So we are starting with fifth now. Okay, we are going to convert it into exclusive form. One second.
So what is the answer of F1?
Okay, F1 we'll do. Okay, E is clear. F, the class mark of the class interval is this one. Okay, this will, I'll explain here, okay? Class mark. Class mark, the mid value. Maybe that, okay, for the time being, you can do this question. If I'm giving writing 0 and 10, what is the mid value class mark means? The middle value. How you to take the middle value? 0 plus 10 divided by 2. This will give you the mean value, the average value. How much it will be? 5. Okay. 15. Okay. 10 and 20. What is the mid value? 10 plus 20 divided by 2. So 15 is the class mark. Is the class mark. It means 5 this side, 5 this side. It's the mid value. That is called as class mark. Okay. Any doubt in this question? Okay. Now see here, class intervals. This is which kind of form? Inclusive or exclusive, is it? It's exclusive form. So whenever you are being asked, write the actual class limits. These are called as actual class limits. Okay, we have done first inclusive class intervals where lower limit was included, upper limit was included. Those are not called as actual class limits. When the table is in the form, when the class intervals are in the form of exclusive form, they are in the exclusive form, the limits are called as actual class limits. These are actual class intervals. These are called as actual class intervals. And the limits are called as actual class limits. So what is the actual lower class limit? Actual lower limit will be, these are the actual lower limits. These are the actual upper limits. Understood? Actual class intervals, you understood? Okay. And actual class intervals, then actual lower limits, actual upper limits. They all are should be. So exclusive form it should be. And then whatever the limits are there, they are actual lower class limits, actual upper class limits are there. Now, to take the class size, what will be the class size? Size of the class. What will be the class size? Upper limit minus lower limit. Actual upper limit minus actual lower limit. How much is this class size? 10. 0. It means 10 can enter in the first class. Second class, what is the class size? 10. So you can see all the class intervals are having the same class size. So class size is 10. Upper class limit, actual upper class limit minus actual lower class limit. If we subtract them, we'll get the class size of the class. We get the class size. Like in your class, what is the limit? What is the class size? 42 students are there. So it means 42 is the class size. Okay. This is clear. Class size is this one. For example, there are 250 students in 9th class. And there are 5 sections. It means we have divided 250 students into 5 classes. Class intervals, 5 classes. Now each class will have how many students? 50 students. This is nothing but class size. This is clear? First class interval, 50 students. Second class interval, 50 students. Like this. This is the class size of the class interval. Okay. And last is the class mark. So how we take the class mark? Upper plus lower divided by 2. That is, we are taking the mean, middle value of each. So here will be 5, here will be 15, 25, 35, 45, 55. These are the class marks. Okay, this is clear. Now how to convert inclusive class intervals into exclusive class intervals we'll be discussing. Okay. So we have to adjust a little bit. We are going to adjust them a little bit. So find the actual lower class limits, upper class limits and the mid values of the classes. So which form they are given? 10 10 to 19, 20 to 19, 29, 30 to 39, 40 to 49. Which kind of class intervals are there? Inclusive or exclusive?
Sir, exclusive.
No, they are inclusive, you can see. 10 to 19, upper limit is included 19. Next, we are starting from 20, 29. It's upper limits are included as well. These are inclusive. These are inclusive. If it was written like this, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, then 40 to 50. Then it was exclusive. That is, we have to exclude the upper class limit. Here, these are inclusive. 10 to 19, then it started from 20 to 29. You can see there is a break. Okay. Our data from 19 to 20, they are not included anywhere. If it comes 19.5, we can't enter in this class. We can't enter this class. So there is discontinuity between each class. Okay. So these are inclusive class intervals. Here 10 is also included. That is 10 is also included. 19 is also included. If data comes 19, it will enter the first class. Similarly here, this is also inclusive class interval. Since lower limit is included, upper limit is included. In exclusive, upper limits are not included. Equal to sign won't be there. Now, how to convert them? So for this year, how we can convert? It means from 19 we will shift, take these two ones. Mainly how the inclusive, exclusive are there. 0 to 10, 10 to 20. Like this, the exclusive limits are there. 10, 10 here. Upper class limit of the first is equal to lower limit of the next. You can see that. Then 20 to 30, 30 to 40. But here they are different. So how to? It means we'll increase 19 a little bit and will decrease 20 a little bit so that they become equal. We'll increase a little bit. So we are going to increase the upper limits a little bit and lower limits we are going to decrease a little bit. That is, we are expanding a little bit. Yes or no? This way. So how to make exclusive? We need that factor. By how much it must be increased? By how much lower limits must be decreased? By how much upper limit must be increased? We need that data. We need that number, or we need that adjustment factor. So how to get that adjustment factor? What we are going to take? We are going to take the upper limit of the first class, or any class you take. Upper limit of one class you take. Okay, first, okay. Upper limit of one class we have taken. And take the lower limit of the next class. So subtract the upper limit of the first class or any class from the lower limit of the next class. Subtract the upper limit of one class from the lower limit of the next. So 20 minus 19, how much? And divide it by 2. So how much you are getting?
0.5.
It means all the upper limits we are going to increase by 0.5. All the lower limits we are going to decrease by 0.5. Okay. All the upper limits we are going to increase by 0.5. All the lower limits we are going to decrease by 0.5. Okay. Subtract 0.5 from 10. How much you are getting? 9.5. Add 0.5 to 19. 19.5. Subtract 0.5 from 20. Lower limits, subtract 0.5. Upper limits, add 0.5. This is our adjustment factor. So 20, it will be 19.5 to 39.5. See here, then 29.5 to 39.5. You can see we have made it exclusive. 9.5 to 19.5. Now see here, 19.5 to 29.5. 29.5, 29.5, 39.5. 39.5 to 49.5. These are exclusive class intervals. How? If 19.5 comes, where it will go? This class interval or this? First or the second class interval? If 19.5 is there, it will go to the second class interval. Lower limits are included, upper limits are excluded. Okay, so it will be 19.5x less than 29.5. No equal to sign here. Here, 9.5, 19.5. Have you understood? Have you all understood? Okay, so these are the actual lower limits and these are the actual upper limits. Okay, in exclusive form only we are taking actual class intervals. These are the actual lower limits, these are the actual upper limits. Understood? Okay, mid values. How to take the mid values? How to take the mid values? Add them, divide by 2. 9.5 plus 19.5 divided by 2. How much it will be? Add them, everyone. Calculate the mid value. How much will it be? 14.5. And here, add 19.5 plus 29.5 divided by 2. 39 divided by 2. 49 divided by 2. How much it will be? 24.5. Next one, 29.5 plus 39.5 divided by 2. Here, see here, mid value doesn't change, whether it's in exclusive form or the inclusive form. Why? Because from the mid value, we have shifted 0.5 extra here. Understood or not? Here we have taken 0, here 19, 10 and 19. So from mid value only we have shifted. See, from 10 we have shifted 0.5 to this side, 0.5. Mid value doesn't change. Whether you take the mid value of here or you take the mid value of here, that does not change. It means class mark doesn't change. Whether you convert from inclusive to exclusive. How much it will be? 30, 69 divided by 2. How much? 34.5. Last is 39.5 plus 49.5 divided by 2. How much it will be? 89 divided by 2. That is 44.5. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Is this clear? Okay. Yes, sir. Do the next question. Okay. Then do the next question, everyone. Find the actual lower and upper class limits and also the class marks of the classes. Okay. Actual means we should have to always make the exclusive form. This we are going to use mainly.
Okay. The way.
So next question, 1.1 to 2. Class intervals are given 1.1 to 2, 2.1 to 3, 3.1 to 4. These are the class. So these are exclusive or inclusive or exclusive. Which kind of intervals these are? Inclusive or exclusive?
Inclusive.
These are inclusive. You can see they are different. It means up to 2 they are included, then from 2.1. It means all the values between 2 and 2.1, they are not included. They are not included. These are inclusive form. Convert to exclusive form, how to convert? So we need the adjustment factor. So take these two, subtract this from this and divide by 2. So adjustment factor. What will be the adjustment factor? 2.1 minus 2 divided by 2. 0.1 divided by 2. How much it is? 0.05. This is the adjustment factor. It means this we have to subtract from the lower limits and we have to add to the upper limits. This we have to subtract from the lower limits and add to the upper limits. This part I am rubbing only. Okay. So this is inclusive form, exclusive form will be here. So subtract it from this one, how much you are getting? 1.05. Add it here, 2.05. This is first class interval. Subtract 2.05. 3.05, 4.05. You can see now 2.05, 2.05. We have made it continuous. Continuous, we have made it. It is exclusive form using the adjustment factors. Okay, mid value won't change because we are shifting 0.5 this side, 0.5 this side. So mid value remains same always. Okay. So actual lower limits and actual upper limits. These are the actual lower limits. For this class, this is the actual lower limit. This will be the upper limit, actual upper limit. Actual lower limit, actual upper limit. Similarly, this. This is clear. And also the class mark. Class mark, how you can calculate? You can calculate class marks of this or this. They remain same. It won't change. So class mark. Mid value you have to take. So add them, divide by 2. How much it will be? Class mark. 1.05 plus 2.05 divided by 2. How much it will be? 3.1 divided by 2. How much it will be? Divided by 31 divided by 2, it will be how much? 1.55 it will be. Okay, next one, 2.05 plus 3.05 divided by 2. So it will be 5.1 divided by 2. Again, 2.55. Similarly, here 3.05 plus 4.05 divided by 2. Okay, so it will be 7.1 divided by 2, 3.55. Okay, you can see the difference. So these are the class marks. Have you all understood up to this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In seventh question, try to list numbers. So which kind of interval these are given? These are inclusive or exclusive? 32, 34, 35 to 30. These are inclusive class intervals. Okay. So when they are asking actual class limits of the fourth class, take the fourth class, convert it into the actual class limits. Okay. Class boundaries of the sixth class. Class boundaries of the sixth class. Simple, whatever the limit are there, you can tell them as the class boundaries. Okay. Class boundaries are the actual class limits. Okay. Class mark of the third class. You can calculate upper and lower limits of the fifth class. Here, they are not asking actual class limits. So you can tell whatever is being given. Upper and class of fifth, first, second, third, fourth, fifth. 50 and 54. Size of the third class, you can calculate, okay? Now, once up in page number 226. Once up in page number 226. So, first thing, class intervals and class limits. Then adjustment factor is there. After the table, see the two lines are there. They are important. The class limits obtained after adjustment are called actual or true class limits. That is also called as true class limits. The actual or true class limits are also called as class boundaries. Actual one, they are called as class boundaries. These two lines mark as important. Okay. Class size, difference between the actual lower limit and actual upper limit. You must remember, you must understand these definitions. Okay. Class mark, class is the value midway between the actual lower limit and the actual upper limit. Understood? So after the table, two lines are given, they are very important. Is this clear? And page number 225, types of frequency distribution, inclusive and exclusive, you must go through those definitions. You can see the difference. It is given on page number 225 and 226 as well. Okay, you must go through this page. Okay, is it clear? So seventh one, try as homework. We'll discuss seventh tomorrow in class. Okay. Okay, so we end the class here. Is this clear? And your examination starts from 26. In class, you have already got one message regarding the dance competition. Okay. So if you want to take the part, okay, Telegram ID, I'll make it today or tomorrow. One or Sunday, I'll make it. And you can send me there afterwards. Okay. Go through that notice. If you want to take part, you can send me the videos. Is this clear? And your examination starts from 26, I think. It may start from 26. Soon you will get the syllabus for the second term and start preparing. Okay. You must emphasize on understanding. Remember that. Okay. So we end the class here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Anything? Thank-